Hey guys and girls, welcome back to some Tokyo Xanadu. I want to apologize about the abrupt end of the last part. I don't know what happened. I just kind of felt super sleepy. So I thought, let me end it here and go rest. But yeah, let's go outside. And let's also start our free time days and go talk to some people. Hiragi? Hello? Tokisaka? What's up? Did something happen? Yes, but it's not that serious. Are you free? Yeah, I've got some time before my shift starts. Okay, well, there's something I need your help with. It's to do with the eclipse. The eclipse? I'm on my way. Where are you? Well, ease down, Tokisaka. It's not an emergency. I want your help with a bit of eclipse hunting. Eclipse hunting? First, let me send the search app to your phone. The search app?
X search system Echo.
Is this it? Echo? Hiragi? What is this? X Search System. The official name is Echo. We just call it the Search App, though. It's a special app we use in this line of work. This little program can detect the eclipse effect and pinpoint the gate. Where the heck did you get this? Never mind. Just tell me how to use it. It's simple. If it detects anything, it'll activate. Easy as that. Try walking around town. If you get a hit, call me. Got it. Also, I sent you a request on Nier. Take a look at it. When you get a sec. Good luck. Hey. And she hung up. Whatever. Might as well walk around town and see what happens.
Eclipse hunting. I guess I'll go to Station Square and look around. She says she also sent me something on Nier. I gotta look at that. Oh. I think the app is pinging something. What the?
Located an eclipse. The percentage display shows the strength of the reading. I should probably check with Hiragi. Tokisaka, have you found anything? Yeah. I got a reading the moment we arrived at Station Square. What's with the percentage displayed on the screen? Gate proximity level. The higher the number, the closer you are to the gate. Keep a close eye on the screen. Be sure to pay attention when it hits 100%. Once you get a max reading, use the installed app to force the gate to appear. Alright, let me give it a shot.
Found it.
I think it's around here. Okay, now to fire up the app and make the gate appear. Easy enough. Holy crap. It worked. It seems like you found it. Hiragi, you already here? This gate, it's a different color than all the others. That color indicates it's phase one, basically. The eclipse is relatively stable and not too dangerous. At least the main enemy of this labyrinth is an Elder Greed, if that helps any. Elder Greeds? Those are the monsters we've been mainly going up against, right? Yes, eclipses with Elder Greeds are in phase two. When they get to that level, a gate to that eclipse can occur spontaneously. The red gates that we've encountered before were of that variety. I see. So this yellow gate will turn red eventually if we don't deal with it right now. Correct. There are some cases where it stays the same for a few years. But there is the possibility of it turning phase 2 instantly, causing Elder Greeds to appear. That's why we have to track them down and take care of them before they have a chance to change. So that's what you've been up to, then. More or less. Anyway, since we found it, let's clear it out. If you need to prepare, take care of that right now. Talk to Sora when you want to head in. Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay. That seems to be main mission, though. I want to do some, like, spending time with people right now. But it doesn't even seem like anyone who I want to spend time with, I can. Who's here? Someone's here in town. She's in Star Camera. Whoever it is. Oh, it's Rion.
That's kind of old. Maybe they don't have it. Wait, this voice. Is that Kugayama? You. You're Tokisaka, right? Really that easy to find me? Well, your voice is pretty unique. Now that I think about it, I haven't seen you around school lately. Yeah, I've been busy with lessons. Being an idol is a lot harder than it looks, alright? You'd never understand.
Jeez, no need to be so prickly. Are you still mad that I didn't accept your autograph?
No. Anyway, just go over there or something. I'm really busy.
She does look like she's searching for something. Let me back it out.
Are you looking for something, Kugayama? I can help.
Well, you wouldn't mind?
I have some time. Consider it an apology for not accepting your autograph.
I said it's fine. Whatever. You're here, so I may as well accept your help.
Prism My Heart. I think I've heard of it. Or maybe not.
Seriously, that's the best you can come up with? It was a huge hit when we were all kids. You don't know a single thing about idols, do you?
My bad. Anyway, I'm supposed to be looking for that idol song.
Yep, I think it'd help us decide which direction the next speaker song should take. It's still pretty popular, so they should have it in stock. I can't find it.
Let's keep looking. Speaking of music, I listened to that one track you gave me the other day. What was it called again? First Telepathy?
Really? What'd you think?
Well, it was good. To be honest, I was kind of surprised.
I know, right? I knew you'd like it. It's our newest song. It's about our first loves. For some reason, it's really popular with our male fans.
It was pretty good, but it felt like something was missing. How do I put this? It doesn't have any real impact. Any gravitas, I guess.
You filthy casual. Talking like you're some kind of expert or something. My god, you're so rude, saying that to the person who sang on it. We'll have to admit the studio version isn't nearly as good as when we do it live.
Are live concerts really that different? Maybe that's why Ryota is so obsessed with going to concerts. Huh? Prism My Heart. Is this it?
You found it? Yeah, this is it. This is Prison My Heart.
So this is it. I get it now. No wonder she was so determined to find the copy.
Phew, I'm glad we were able to find the copy. The song, kind of means a lot to me.
Oh, really? Well, it is pretty upbeat and cheerful. I could see myself listening to it whenever I feel tired or kind of down.
I know, right? Anyway, thanks for helping me find it. I'll make you a speaker fan yet. Just wait for our next song. Got it. I'll be waiting.
Mutt.
Come on, bro. Bro, come on. Alright. Let's go talk to, our cousin.
Just to be clear on this, do not tell anyone. I won't. God.
There. Done. Miss Kokonoe, is this okay? Yep, that's fine. Miss Kokonoe and Mr. Goro. Oh, I guess you didn't mention that you had work in Comp Lab. Is it a project with Mr. Goro? Goro?
I had planned on doing it by myself, but Mr. Goro was kind enough to offer his help.
It's nothing. I just happened to pass by. She looked like she could use a hand carrying in these terminals.
New terminals? Yep, we're installing high-spec machines this year. In this day and age, it's crucial to have modern hardware. If students can use state-of-the-art equipment here, then they can put those skills to work outside.
Miss Kokonoe teaches computer classes in addition to math. She's been hounding the vice principal to get us outfitted with new stuff since she started. She worked long and hard adjusting the budgets to make this possible, and she did it all for you kids. I had no idea.
It's nothing. I just thought it'd be best to have these in place before we get to the main part of the lessons. I'm glad you were around to help, Mr. Goro.
My pleasure. That's what we teachers do for each other. There's only about half of them left, so let's get this done.
Oh, let me help too, since I'm already here. Thanks, Cal.
Oh, you didn't drop by specifically to help?
Of course not. I just happened to pass by.
Toa overworking herself as always.
Wow. Seeing it all in place looks pretty cool. By the way, what's that big thing over there?
That's what'll be the main machine here in the lab. It'll be the central unit of the classroom and assist in the processing power.
That's all Greek to me, but sounds like it must be pretty powerful.
Just a few more terminals and we'll be good to go.
Well, Miss Kokonoe, I'll take my leave. Goodbye, Tokisaka.
Yeah, bye. Thank you very much.
That didn't count as, like, doing the thing. He made a mistake and sent the wrong parts without on the computers. Should I stop my star camera? Yeah, let's hang out with Toa. Yeah.
favorite, one of our favorite characters. Me and Toa head to Star Camera. Toa finds the new parts she needs for the computers. Let's see. What else do I need? Okay, that's everything. Thanks, Ko. I guess we should head back to school now. Ko, are you okay? Don't strain yourself. Why don't I carry half of that? Don't worry. This is nothing. Considering how tiny you are, even half of this stuff would bury you. Hey, I'm not that small. But thanks for helping, really. It's nice to know you haven't changed all that much. I could swear that we've done this before. You mean like deja vu? Huh? Toa, is that you? Oh, hello, Professor. What brings you here?
I was just coming back from a meeting of a research society. And how about you? I take it this is the younger brother you've said so much about?
That's correct. Not quite. I'm her cousin. And you are?
Oh, excuse me. I teach information processing at a university. I've known Toa since we were lab partners.
Oh, he knows Toa from college.
Ah, the memories. I remember her dissertation being truly novel and revolutionary. The mathematics department, in particular, was really sorry to see you go.
Thanks.
Your departure was unfortunate, but educating the young is crucial for the future of academics. You teach at Morimiya Academy, right? I wish you the best of luck. But if you ever change your mind, please don't hesitate to get in touch.
Thank you very much.
Now, if you'll excuse me, you know you can learn a lot from your sister.
Thanks. That's right. I remember hearing something about that before. So you really were offered a faculty position at your university. Yeah. After I graduated, they wanted me to stay on and as a researcher in the lab.
So what made you decide to come to Morimiya Academy? I mean, you could have realized your full potential at the university. To be honest, I don't understand why you turned them down.
Well, there's something else I wanted to do outside of research.
What's that?
I think I'll keep it a secret for now. Let's keep going, Ka. We need to hurry before it gets dark.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I still don't get it, but I'll drop the subject for now.
My friendship with Toa deepened. Alright. Now let's go Eclipse hunting. Good. Let's go.
I see. I didn't know a gate was here.
Sorry about this, Sora. I'm also sorry for calling you out here, even though this has nothing to do with the club.
It's alright. I'm just glad I'm able to help.
Thanks. Well, let's get going.
There's a powerful S-tier greed lurking in the heart of the labyrinth. Let's just get through it as quickly as possible and then defeat it. Got it.
Exploring a free dungeon or a previously cleared area, you can exit at any time you wish. Alright. His raging gear hits in a wide area. Her skills are easy to use and highly effective. And extremely agile. Flurry of attacks, basically. Okay. I'm gonna bring these two in though and have her on support. Since these two are currently my weakest, I want them in harm's way, so to speak. Alright. Let's get through this. Bastard. Oh, whatever. Back, I guess. Treasure! Open! Opera glass. Did I try that way? Oh no, there's a switch there. That. Whatever. It's not cool. Don't sit on me.
Ooh, double kill.
That was nice. That went through both of them. Jeez. Oops, I did not mean to do that. I just wasted that. Damn it. I meant to do that. I screwed up.
Phew, not sure how we managed to defeat it. I guess it's safe to assume this is the master of this labyrinth. While it was strong, it's similar to the other greeds wandering about, and it wasn't that hard to beat. Agreed. It must have been an orc type that evolved into an Ezgreed. Though not as powerful as Elder Greeds, you still need to stay on your toes. Sometimes you'll come across some very powerful Ezgreeds lurking in the shadows. And the moment you let your guard down against one, one could prove fatal. Don't scare us like that.
I'll keep that in mind.
For now. Let's head to the gate that should have opened up ahead. We can return to reality from there.
Yeah.
Roger. What's that?
I wonder what all of those symbols on it means.
Think of it as a slot machine. Like the relic is, it's something you'll come across in the eclipse. If your timing is on point, you might be able to procure some rare eclipse materials.
Why in the hell is it even?
Truly a place of many mysteries. Let's try it out.
That's weird, but okay.
It's just like the one we saw in Brick Alley. But what's with the tremors?
Connection?
Can't we just make it go away? Like the last time?
Unfortunately not.
From its appearance, the connection it has to this place is exceptionally strong. For now, all we can do is wait and see.
Really?
I think leaving it as is a really bad idea. Anyway. Thanks for calling in help for this, Hiragi.
I didn't do anything. I just wanted to make things easier for everyone.
That's a legit reason. This kind of thing isn't something you should be dealing with alone anyway.
Cool. You're right. That's my job, though. Whatever.
Don't worry. I'll spend more time eclipse hunting from now on. Sora, I'm definitely going to need your help whenever I have to head into an eclipse.
Yes, of course. Thanks for helping out.
By the way, Hiragi, you were out looking for signs of an eclipse today, right? Find any?
Nope. I went to all of the usual places, but I didn't come across anything to worry about. I think I'm going to go home for the day and relax a little.
Asuka, where are you staying?
At the cafe, coffee shop 17 in Brick Alley. I live in one of the apartments on the second floor. If anything comes up, that's where you can find me. Stop by anytime.
Yes, thank you. If something does come, you'll definitely be the first person I talk to.
When I said stop by anytime, I was talking to Sora. I'm joking.
Gems. Ko's virtue increased. Okay. Oh, we got a free time from that. So you clear the free dungeons, you get a shard to mess around with people. Who's the green-haired? Oh, that's my other friend, right? My other... whatever his name was. Well, we're just gonna go. I'm not really in the mood to spend time with someone right now.
Horaitra has a cool vibe to it. I mean, it's where people come to have fun. Of course, since it's noon on a weekday, the place is deader than disco. Horaitra is more of me as an entertainment district. With many bars, nightclubs, and pubs, it's bustling with people at night. The gig is at a cafe/bar today, but there are a bunch of other businesses around as well. Arcade Oasis has several mini-games to enjoy. You can exchange the medals for prizes. The pawn shop, Dekokudo, is where you can barter for rare items. There are many facilities in town that you can use to your advantage.
Cool. Immediately, this arcade stands out to me, and I want to go to it. So let's check it out. This is the heroine of some anime that June or Sabura probably like. Fairy Mona's friend Michi is here to ask for the help of magical girl Alyssa. After many things happened, the evil Michi plotted to throw Alyssa into an alternate dimension. Fight me if you want to escape, Gah. Wielding the mysterious hammer, Alyssa rises to the challenge to save Michi. Seems interesting enough. I'll give it a go sometime. Alyssa. I wonder if this is like a reference to the one from Cold Steel. Because she sort of looks like the Alyssa from that. And this is like just Tetris. Oh no, this is I mean, it looks like Tetris. I don't know. Gate of Avalon. Can I play the crane game? There's a new game. Gate of Avalon. Use the card game Blade at your nearby store or play online with Xiphone version users. Players will be matched based on skill level. Oh, this is. Oh, I can play it. Okay. So this is the card game I got in this collector's edition, but in game form, like in the game, I think. Matching lobby. Oh, I need medals. I don't have any medals to do so. Can I exchange money for some medals? Is that a thing? Let me talk to the lady up front. Yeah, I'll take 100. Explosive fishing demon. With Reen. That's funny. Oh my god. This is Reen. So they have mini games involving the Cold Steel characters with Demon Prince Reen. Ebel Highway. These are places from Lake Lacrima. Let's go to Ebel Highway. These are places from the Cold Steel game. Oh my gosh. That's Reen and his DLC outfit. That's pretty funny.
Bakuchou Yuki. With Matao.
The Vantage Masters. I barely played this game before. I have other stuff to take care of, so I should skip it. No, play it!
That's Estelle. You have to play it, damn it. This is literally just Trails in the Sky, I think. That's what it looks like. It might be like S3 or something. I don't know. But that's Estelle for sure. Can I play these? No. He doesn't want to play it. I can play this one. Michi Panic, Magical Girl with Elisa. Let's do it easy for now. Yeah, this is Elisa. This is her. From Code Steel. That's a good one, right? That's pretty funny. Because that's so her. He doesn't want to play that one either. Alright, last game to play is Gates of Avalon. See who I play. Hey, you seem familiar. I'm the campaign girl from Star Camera. In this game, you play it in Cold Steel as well. So I mean, like, this is in of itself a reference to the Cold Steel game. Let's blast her cards. This one. Drop a 5. Well then. Damn it. I was never good at this game. Alright, I lost. Yeah, that's pretty cool that Wolverine and Alyssa are in this in a pawn shop here. Don't know what I could possibly get here, but yeah, I won't worry about it. Alright, let's go to work. Alright, so we're reaching about close to an hour. So I'm going to end it here. We're going to go to work on the next part. Thanks for watching, guys. Leave a like, subscribe, share with a friend. I hope you guys enjoyed. And yeah, I'll see you then.